If you've watched more than a couple of my videos, you've seen it. It's been there all along. Inconspicuous, appearing to be nothing more than a decoration for the set. It, deceptively, looks to be nothing more than a bottle of whiskey. Or, as I call it, Tennessee Tylenol. But no, there is no whiskey in that bottle. There hasn't been for a very long time. However, what is in the bottle? Well, it has a purpose. And now, the time has come for that purpose to be revealed. Folks, thank you for clicking on the video. Welcome to the channel. As always, I appreciate it when you take your precious time to stop by the channel, see what I'm doing, check things out. And today, I don't know, this is kind of special for me because this is something that I've literally had in the works since before I ever even posted my first video. It was a concept that I came up with when I first decided to have a channel. I just thought, you know, down the road, this would be something that would be kind of cool to do. So I started it. And yes, it all has to do with this particular, now empty, bottle of Jack Daniels. Well, it's not a bottle of Jack Daniels anymore because, well, sadly, at some point, all the Jack Daniels went away. And I'm not really sure how that happened, but, well, yeah. That said, no, once it was empty, I decided, hey, perfect place to throw all of my spare change, and, well, not all of it, because I only put the silver, the quarters, the dimes, the nickels. I put those in here. I've got another bucket for pennies, but quarters, dimes, and nickels. And I thought, you know, let's see, how much of my spare change, random change, once it gets to the top, can't fit anything else in, how much money, how much would it add up to? And then, on top of that, well, naturally, you got a Jack Daniels bottle full of change. Well, why not turn it into a guitar? So, with however much change was in here, and yes, this thing was full all the way to the top, couldn't fit another dime in, how much guitar can I get out of it? That's the thing. So, as you can see, it's empty. I've pulled all the change out. I've got quarters. I've got nickels. These are the dimes. I've separated all the change. I haven't counted it yet, though. I haven't got a clue what's there. I've got a few guesses. Maybe you're guessing right now. In fact, go ahead and guess. Just pause the video. Go ahead and comment below. Give me your guess. Don't cheat. Come on. Don't cheat. Right now, later on in the video, you're going to know how much money was there. But for right now, don't cheat. Just tell me what you think. How much change, random change, fits in a Jack Daniels bottle. But the deal is, all that change is going to go to the bank, and I should take this moment to shout out to Miss Grumpy, because she's volunteered to actually be the one. She's going to take that to the bank probably tomorrow and get it all counted up and deposited into the account. And once that happens, once I get a total, I'm going to try to decide which guitar I can buy. Now, there's plenty of candidates. Certainly, I guarantee I can get a Harley Benton. Although, number one, I've bought the lower end, lower price range Harley Benton guitars, or at least three of the electrics and an acoustic. So I've had a little bit of experience with Harley Benton, and they're great guitars. But maybe I want something a little different. Maybe a Squire. The Toronado was fantastic. And I also have to tell you, somebody has brought me a 2008 Squire Strat that I'm kind of in love with. They brought it to me to do a few repairs and a setup on. I've been working on that guitar. I got to order some parts for it. But Squires, I've really changed my opinion about Fender Squires. So maybe a Squire, maybe something else. I've got a few other things in mind. So what will I buy? Well, just stick around because it's going to happen. See, for me, it'll be a few days from now. But for you, well, it's going to happen just like that. It's almost like time travel, right? Because it's been about a week. All that change, it's been counted up. It's been cashed in, deposited in the bank. I know the figure. I know exactly how much it was. And beforehand, I had kind of had a guess. I was guessing it would be around $300 because, well, it was more of a hope. Because there was a guitar in particular that I kind of was hoping would be the one, but I needed it to be around $300. So did it get there? Well, I'm not telling you yet because I want to know what you get. Did you pause the video? Did you make a guess for yourself? Because if you guessed $274.30. Well, then you're a winner. You are a winner. And because you're a winner, you are going to wait, you know what? Even if you didn't guess it, I think you're all winners. I think you're a winner. I think you're a winner. I certainly think you're a winner. And you there in the back, well, you're okay, you're a winner too. Everybody's a winner, and because everybody's a winner, you are all going to get the imaginary Grumpy Mike home board game. And it's great, trust me. This thing is fantastic. And well, here's all you have to do to get the Grumpy Mike imaginary home board game. If you're at home and you're bored, imagine that there is a Grumpy Mike game, and then you play it. You're welcome. Anyway, yes, it fell short of my $300 goal. I really did want that guitar. So it kind of, I had to go to work. I had to start doing some research. I looked at some Harley Bentons, but shipping, all that, with everything, you know, apparently there's some strange things that have been going on in the world this whole year that might affect shipping. So it kind of, I hate to say it, discouraged me away from the Harley Benton guitars. I looked at Squires, and specifically, I was kind of thinking a Tele. Because I'm kind of getting into a Tele mood. There are actually multiple Teles that I want. So I figured that could be an option. And I gave some attention to some Ibanez guitars. But I kept coming back to that one guitar that I had in mind to begin with. But the rules of the game here, I've got $274.30 to play with. Then a miracle happened. I couldn't believe it. I'm flipping through my email one day and I get an email from Guitar Center. Now, and let me just say, my initial plan was to order whatever guitar from Sweetwater, because honestly, never really ordered from Sweetwater before. Don't have any kind of a relationship with them, and I really want to try Sweetwater out. So that was initially my plan. But I get this email from Guitar Center, and it's a coupon. Coupons. I love coupons. Yeah, coupons. And it's given me, it's a VIP. Apparently, I'm a VIP when it comes to Guitar Center, because that's what it said. Because I am a VIP customer, they're sending, and probably, I guess everybody gets them, either that or VIP stands for very incompetent player. I'm not sure. Something like that, but I got a coupon, and it was for 16% off, and I started running the numbers, and I'm like, oh, look. And as it turns out, they actually had one at the Guitar Center right down the road from me. I got a coupon. It's right down the road from me. I'd better go get it. So, what did I pick? What guitar did I pull out of a whiskey bottle? Well, yes, indeed, folks, I pulled a Gretsch out of a whiskey bottle. That's right, a Gretsch Junior Jet Club, which comes in right at the $300 range. Now, there's a version of it that has a P90 in the neck that I think is about 50 bucks more, but this one with the two Broadtron pickups in it, it comes in at 300 bucks, and because I had a coupon, I was able to buy it with the money out of my whiskey bottle, and I'm happy I did. I've kind of had my eye on this guitar ever since one of my very favorite YouTubers, maybe my favorite Canadian YouTuber, Mr. Ben Coombs. And by the way, if you're not subscribed to Ben Coombs's channel, you do yourself a favor, go ahead. I like watching his videos. He tells you what he thinks when he reviews something, and he'll go through everything, and he's not one of these snobbish kind of guys who, oh, this is, no, he goes by what he hears. I just subscribe to Ben. Anyway, I saw him review this guitar, well, not this guitar, because the one he reviewed was the natural wood grain, looked kind of maybe, I guess, it maybe a walnut sort of stain, maybe, I don't know, could be mahogany, I don't know, sort of a darker wood grain color. I would have preferred that one myself. They didn't have it in stock at the Guitar Center, but the more I looked at the gold dust, and that's what this is, it's sort of a sparkle metallic gold color, the more I looked at it, kind of like my Harley Benton gold top SC450 with the P90s. That gold top kind of grew on me, and this color here has been growing on me. I like it. It kind of has kind of a classy look to it. But Nevertheless, I saw Ben's review. I was very interested. I liked the tones he was getting out of it. I like Filtertron pickups, as a matter of fact. So everything about it made me want to get one, and this was the perfect opportunity to do it. So now I'm not going to do a full demo and review right now. Down the road I will. I'm still learning a few things. You know, I've got to do a setup on it. It actions like most guitars when you get them. At least for me, my experience is it doesn't matter if it's a PRS, a Gibson, a Fender, whatever it is, I'm generally going to probably lower the action just a tad, which is funny because I'm not real into super low actions, but it seems like they always usually come, you know, with a slightly higher action than what I like. So I'll do a little bit of adjustment to make it play my way. And then down the road, I'll probably do a little bit of a review. Just for now, the pickups, they call them Broadtrons, probably on the lower spectrum, lower end of the spectrum for Filtertron pickups. They're certainly not TV Jones pickups, but that said, they sound pretty good. I like the way they sound. You got your single one-piece wraparound compensated bridge, and yes, it has the adjustments here. You can do a fair amount of intonating with them, although the guitar is pretty well intonated. I don't think I'll have to do a whole lot of adjustment there. One of the things I don't like about a lot, not all, but about a lot of the Gretsch guitars, I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of the thumbnail inlays. I prefer nice block perloid or abalone or anything, block inlays, dot inlays even. The thumbnails, not necessarily a big fan of, but that's generally what you'll get with a lot of the Gretsch guitars, and I know a lot of people like them. I'm just not a huge fan, but it didn't stop me. If this guitar has one weak link, and I wish companies would quit doing this, and it doesn't matter, Fender, you know, Harley Benton, and yes, Harley Benton, you expect them to cheap out on some parts somewhere. I get it. But Fender, well, Squires will do it. Epiphone, and that's the cheapy tuners. That's the one thing about this guitar that makes this guitar, well, it's $150 Harley Benton has just as good of tuners as this guitar does. Now, this guitar costs twice as much more. Come on, guys. Let's do a little better on the tuners. These are going to have to go. I like this guitar so far well enough to know that I'm going to be keeping it at least for a while. And in order to do that, I'm going to have to order some tuners to go on it, because these can't stay. Other than that, however, I like pretty much everything about it. I've enjoyed playing it, and I'm going to continue enjoy playing it. And not too bad for a guitar that was pulled out of a whiskey bottle. So I hope you've enjoyed this, and I hope the title of the video wasn't too clickbaity, but technically that's exactly what I did. I pulled a guitar out of a whiskey bottle. So I'm going to set this over here to the side, so I have the opportunity to, well, just to remind you, you know the deal. Just right down there below. It won't take you but just a second, just go ahead and click that subscribe button and ring the bell while you're at it so you get notifications. All the subscriptions help. Hitting that like button certainly helps. And it kind of makes me feel, you know, a little warm and fuzzy inside when you do so. But you don't have to. You can click that thumbs down. It doesn't bother me. And I should also mention that I certainly welcome your comments. If you have any questions, anything, you can ask me anything. I can't guarantee you I'll answer anything, but you can ask me anything. If you have any questions about the Gretsch Junior Jet Club, feel free. So comment, like, share, certainly subscribe, ring the bell, all that good stuff. And I think that's going to be just about it for the video. I can't think. Oh, I guess there's one more thing that probably I should do. Hang on. Oh, yep. Here we go. Let's start it up again. Be good. Let's all just be good. Take care.